show online gaan. In this video I will be demonstrating the MIDI real-time harmonizer. The MIDI harmonizer is based on the Max platform of Cycling 74. The MIDI harmonizer is a standalone application that can run both on Mac as well as on PC. Basically, the MIDI harmonizer will take an input note via MIDI and will generate a four-note chord as MIDI output. In the MIDI harmonizer, you can program 8 different chords that will be played one at a time, each time you play a note. So, for example, when I play a note, a chord is being generated. And when I repeat the same note, different chords are being generated. And when I play different notes, the chords will be played relatively to the input note, so the chords will be transposed following the note that I play. Typically, the MIDI harmonizer can be used both in the studio running on your favorite digital audio workstation, as well as on stage running on a PC or a Mac. It will sit between the input signal coming from your instrument and the MIDI output signal going to your synthesizer or plug-in instrument. Let me show you how to use the MIDI harmonizer. First of all, you can program four-note chords here on the right side. Just click on four notes to create a four-note chord like this. I just click on four notes like this, and you have created my first chord. Now you can repeat this for all of the 8 chords within the preset. The reference note is the note indicated by the dark vertical line, as you can see here. And is always identical to the input note. In most cases, you want the highest note of your chord to be identical to the reference input note. So if I have now created a preset of 8 chords, the MIDI harmonizer will pick a different chord each time I play a note, like this. The indicator on the right, as you can see, on the right side of the chord will blink when that specific chord is being played. Now I can either have the MIDI harmonizer play the chords in sequence or in a random manner. By clicking the random switch over here, I determine the way the chords are being played. So for example, if I click it here, the chords are being played randomly. Now if I unclick it again, the chords are being played sequentially. Here's an example of a preset where the highest note of the chord is not identical to the reference note. As you can see over here, the third chord and the fifth chord and the seventh, they all have a higher note, which is 4 semitones higher than the reference note. And it sounds like this when I play the same note every time again. In this way, you can create all kinds of unexpected chords. There's the possibility to define a negative offset velocity for the lower 3 notes in the chord. These notes will get a lower velocity, often meaning that their volume is turned down compared to the highest note. So, for example, when I keep changing the velocity offset, you will get this result. Thank you. You can also define how many notes are being played in the chord, all four notes or less than four notes. It will sound like this. There is a bypass switch that will turn the harmonizer on and off. The bypass can be invoked by quickly turning up the pitch wheel two times, like this. As you can see, the bypass switch is on, and now the bypass switch is off. So it will sound like this.